Hi. Oh, good. I got it to work. This thing is stressful, let me tell you.
I'm going to attempt to do this with my preschoolers Wednesday.
Aw, fun.
Yeah, I got to figure out how to do it myself first.
Yeah, I know. It's like, it seems very simple, but I think I'm complicating things for.
And I will overthink things and do the same.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Let me get, we'll wait just a moment here. Get a couple more people going, see who's here.
Do we need anything today?
Yes, 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 yes. Thank you for asking as I'm fooling around. Okay, if you have an elevated surface, it doesn't necessarily need to be a chair or a bench. If you have a couch or anything like that, you can use that. We're gonna put our feet on that. And then if you have dumbbells, two or even just one is fine. If you don't have dumbbells, don't even worry about it. Doesn't matter. So we'll take a few minutes. Get that started. I gotta get Facebook going here. It's funny, it won't do it when I rotate my phone or my iPad. There we go. You should see all the contraptions in my house. It's so funny. And I tell everybody, stay away. Leave me alone. All right, you guys. So get your dumbbells if you have them. Get your elevated surfaces if you have them. Your water, your coffee, your towel, whatever you have, okay? And we're going to get started. You'll hear beeping in my video. And the only reason I'm doing that today we're doing everything for reps instead of time, but I'm going to have the timer going off because it seems to work better on Facebook as an interruption in music rather than kicking me totally off and like hearing a regular song since I don't own the rights to the music. All right. Okay. I am going to make sure you guys make sure you mute yourselves, please. Let me see, manage participants. I'm gonna do that, mute all. It should mute you all. So I'm not gonna hear anything that you have to say, okay? All right, let's get started. All right, you see me okay? All right, starting. We're just going to do hamstring curls. So heel, 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 just warming things up here. Keeping it nice and light to start. Bringing those hamstrings into front ankle touch. Gonna get in that external rotation, warming up those hips. Keep going. I'm gonna fix this camera angle so you can see down by my mat too, because we'll be on the floor for a little bit. All right, now we're gonna go hamstring, ankle touch. hamstring, ankle touch. Hamstring, ankle touch. We're alternating between the two. Oh, I messed that one up, didn't I? Hamstring, ankle touch. Apparently I can't talk into it. Hamstring, ankle touch. Here we go. Few more. Let's go two. Last one. Going right into high knees. Pump those arms. Try to get your knees hip height. Five, four, three, two, go butt kickers. Heels to your butt. Keep pumping those arms. Four, three, two, right to jumping jacks. All the way up, all the way down. Remember, if you're not jumping, you can keep it low. Okay, whatever you need to do. All right, you be coming up now. Five, four, three, two, and we shake it out. Shake it all out. Nice and easy, relax. Then we're gonna start with our world's greatest stretch, okay? Hinging forward from the hip. Upper body hangs down. Feel those hamstrings, here we go. Walk it out, push up. Lunge. Twist, step back and switch. Lunge, twist, step back, walk it back, stand it up. Do it again, walk it out. We've got five of these. Good push-ups, even if it means that you need to drop to your knees, that is okay. We're here doing what we can today. Hinge forward, walk it out, push up, good range of motion, twist, opening that thoracic spine, opening those hips. You might feel a few back cracks, I do, feels good. No pain there, okay? Keep it going, this is number four. We got one more, walk it back. Stand it up. Last time here. Push up. Make it good. Then walk it back. Wide feet. Crouch it down. Chest is open. Hands on those toes. Heels down. Straighten the legs. Down. Straighten the legs. Open through the chest. Three, four, five. Ooh, hamstrings are tight today. Six, seven. Ran some hills yesterday. Eight, nine. I hope you guys got out. 10. I know the weather wasn't nice, but Being cooped up doesn't help. Here we go. We're going to roll it up. Nice. Open and close those arms. Big hugs around the body. Switching the arm on top. And then we'll go one arm, circle it back. Keep your hips square, allow the torso to rotate. Roll it forward. Switch it, other side. Rolling forward. And shake it all out. Tuck your chin and let your head roll side to side. Keep those shoulders down and relax. It should feel nice. Adjust this a little bit more. There we go. All righty. We are going to start off with some, we're gonna do three sets of push-ups, squats, and sit-ups. Squats will be first since we're standing, go down for push-ups, and then come up for, stay down for sit-ups. We're doing 10 of each. I want you guys to go at your own pace. 10 reps, three times through. Squats, push-ups, sit-ups, okay? Full sit-ups if you can. If you have any tailbone injuries, back injuries, just keep it into a crunch, okay? We're gonna start with those squats. Here we go, 10 times. Down, two, three. Eight, nine, 10, right down for push-ups. One, two, three, four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Sit-ups. One, two. Think about giving elbows to knees. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 10. Coming up, do it again. Let's go. Gotta get warmer. Ten push-ups. Ten. Sit-ups. Let's go. One more round. Squats. Nine, 10, push-ups. All right, sit up. Here's nine. One more. Bring it up. Get a quick drink. Let that heart rate come down a little bit. All good? weight should be up. Finish up if you're not done yet. Okay? Looking good, you guys. Perfect. Beautiful. All right, quick drink. So we're going to grab one dumbbell. One dumbbell. We're going to bring that dumbbell overhead. The idea is to try and keep your arms overhead. Let the legs do the work. Going split jumps. Alternating, we're going for 20 total. So arms overhead. You're dropping down into that split jump. Back knee is down or bent. Up. Other leg. Up. Down. Up. All right. 20 times total. Get ready for it. Arms overhead. Here we go. Down. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10 more. One. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20. All right. Keeping that same dumbbell. The hand you have your dumbbell in is facing forward. The other foot is turned out. That arm reaches up. Keep it overhead. The other palm forward. Hinge from the hip. You want to look up to your dumbbell. Come down as low as you can. You can bend the knee if you need to. Come all the way up. It just depends on your flexibility in your hamstring, okay? We're going for 10 each side. Slow and controlled. Down. One. Come all the way up. Shoulders over hips. Two. Look at that dumbbell. Three. Inhale down. Exhale up. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. We switch it. And switch your feet. Turn that toe out. Your heels line up with each other. Arm overhead. Here we go. Inhale down. Exhale. One. Look at that dumbbell. Two. Come all the way up. Shoulders over hips. Three. Four. Five. Extend that arm. Six. Lock it out. Seven. Eight. Nine. One more here. Beautiful. Putting that down. We have a mule kick up into a sit through. So we're going to come down into a bit of a piked position. We're going to kick our heels up, hips rise over shoulders. When we come down, we step one foot forward to the outside of your hand. You will pick that hand up and kick your foot through. Coming back, then that foot that stepped forward kicks up. Step the other foot to the outside of your hand. Pick that hand up, kick through. I'm not sitting on the floor. Back, and then this one kicks up. Again, if you're not kicking up, that's fine. Just step back. So you'll be here, forward, kick, back, forward, kick. Okay? That's for without the kick. You want to add more? Do the kick. All right? Let's go for 12 total. So it'll be six each side. Ready? Here we go. Kick. Up. Two. Three. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. 2 more. 1. 2. All right, bring it up. Going for our wall sit. So grab a wall. Sitting back. Hips in line with the knees. Knees over the ankles. We're going for time on this one. Ready? Hold it up. Draw the navel in towards the spine. Shoulders touch the wall. Breathe. Keep those arms up. We're gonna dance a little bit. Come on, stay with it. 30 seconds. Woo! Push through those heels. Keep them down. Sit down. 10 seconds. Three, two, bring it up. Woo! Shake it out. Are you ready for what's next? Squat jumps 180 degrees. So we're gonna do a half rotation. Okay? So you're gonna squat down. As you explode up, you rotate. Squat. Rotate. All right? Let's go for 20 of them. Do 10 rotating one way, then do 10 rotating the opposite direction. Here we go. Squat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Woo! Shaking out those legs. We're gonna go through our whole series. And then we're gonna start back at the top. So we're gonna keep moving here. We're gonna grab those dumbbells. Come onto your back. So one will do. If you only have one, hold it up here. If you have two, let's grab two. We're gonna keep this right above our chest, okay? Try to keep your palms facing forward. And we're going to go for alternating leg lowers. So we start with our legs up. So depending on flexibility, you might not be able to get here. You can get here if your hamstrings are tight, okay? I don't want you here. I'd rather here. Keep those legs straight. Draw the navel down. Small of your back is pressed into the floor. You're going to lower one leg. It does not touch. And bring it up. Down and up. There we go. Alternate. Right. Left. Make sure you lower. Come back up. Then switch. Other side lowers. It comes back up. That's 4. 5. 6, 7, 8, we're doing 20, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
Last one, I want you to hold it up here. Beautiful. We're gonna slowly lower the legs down. Pull the knees in, tuck, straighten the legs. Slowly lower down. Knees in, tuck, straighten the legs. That's two. Slow lower, don't touch the floor. Knees in, straight, three. We're only doing 10 here. Knees in, up. Make sure the small of that back does not come off the floor. Good, I think that's four. In, up, five to go. In, up, six. Seven. In, straight legs up. Eight, we got two more. Hang in there. Nine. In and up, 10, beautiful. We can put those dumbbells down to the sides here. Bring your heels in where the knees are bent, but it's still kind of difficult for you to reach the heels. I don't want you to be able to touch them because we're gonna go into a bit of a crunch position, lifting our head and shoulders off of the floor, extending the arms down. Keep your chin tucked into your chest, looking at the space between the legs, and then you're going to reach, touch heel or ankle. Alternating sides, here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six. Keep shoulders up. Eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Let's do 10 more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 30. Bring it back down. We're staying right here. So we're gonna bring those knees up. Knees over hips, shins parallel to the ground. 90 degree bend in the knees. Lift the head and shoulders off the floor. Beautiful. We're gonna do three times 15 seconds, okay? Extend the leg out, ankle in line with shoulder. Extend the leg out, small of the back is down. Then extend the arms overhead. If your back comes up, bring it back in, okay? We're going to that whole hollow body hold. Ready? Hold it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, one, two, three, four, five. Pull those knees in, rest. Woo, you should feel that. Only in your belly. I don't want you to feel it in your back. If you feel it in your back, it's because you're probably lowering the legs too much or going to a level that's too difficult for you. So adjust. Ready? We're gonna do it again. Hold it. Out. One, two, three. Biceps by your ears, if you can. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, one, two, three, four, five. Bring it in. Woo! Rest the head and everything. Big hug. All right, we're gonna do it one more time before we move on. All right, and head up, shoulders up, arms and legs out. Hold. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. One, two, three, four, and five. Pull it in. Oh, so good. All right, going to that elevated surface. Again, if you have a couch, a chair, whatever you have, if you don't have it, you're just going to do a bridge, okay? Where your feet are on the floor, and you're gonna go up and down. To make that more difficult, you do it with one leg, all right? Same goes for you on the elevated surface. So I'm gonna use my window ledge here, okay? And this is called a butt plank. Instead of like a bridge, how we have bent knees, we're gonna keep our legs straight. So you're gonna be at the crown of my head here. You'll still be able to see me. Legs are up, okay? And then We are gonna go hips up. Either both at the same time or one at a time. If you're doing one at a time, we're doing 10 each leg. If you're doing both, you're staying with 20. All right, ready? Bring it up. Here we go. Straight leg. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Switch legs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. Beautiful. All right. We've got one more. One more before we start the whole thing over again. So you just need one dumbbell. Going into a plank, you're going to take your dumbbell. Yeah, let me move this. You're going to take your dumbbell on the outside. Your hands are in front of your dumbbell. Going into a plank position. Remember, we're not sagging here, okay? Keep it lifted. You're gonna take your hand, reach underneath the arm, grab that dumbbell. Place it to the other side. Put your hand down, do a push-up. Then switch it. Other hand reaches under the arm, place it to the side, do a push-up, all right? Here we go. Let's start it off. Grab it. Push-up. One. We're going for 12 of these. Two. Count every time after you push-up. Three. Four. Five. Halfway there. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. One. Two and nine. Excellent. Finish those up, get a quick drink, wipe your sweat. We're gonna do it all again, starting with that overhead split jump. You guys are doing great, I see you. You look great, look strong. Now's the time, we gotta be warriors, right? You heard, we got 30 more days of this, right? It's an opportunity to get 30 days stronger. All right, are you ready? We're going for those overhead split jumps. We have 20. Grab one dumbbell. Remember, you don't need it if you don't have it. Overhead. Here we go. Drop down. One. Two. Three. You can always just lunge back. Four, right? Five. That's your option. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. One. Two. Three. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine and 20. Beautiful. Holding on to that dumbbell. Turn opposite foot out. Arm straight overhead. We've got windmills. Down and up. We've been through it once. We're going to move a little bit quicker through it. You should know what you're doing. Two. Inhale down. Exhale up. three, maybe a, we'll say four, five, six. Look up at your dumbbell. Seven. Come all the way to stand. Eight. Nine. 10. You feel those obliques working on that one. Here we go. Other side. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. Excellent. We've got those mule kickups to the sit through. Remember your option. If you are not kicking up, just step back. If you kicked up last time, maybe try to kick a little bit higher. Again, you don't have to go so high, okay? I think it's just fun. Just feels good. Are you ready? Here we go. We step through for that kick through. Okay, we got 12. Up. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Halfway there. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. One. And two. Woo, wall sits. Find your wall. Come on down. Let me get my timer. Three, two, here we go. Belly's in, flatten your back out. Steady your breath here. Stay with me, push through those heels. Hold on, hold on, hold on, we got 10. Five, four, three, two. Bring it up, bring it up. Oh, yes. Shake it out. And then we get to go right into 180 degree squat jump. Burn them up. Are you ready? 10 times one way, 10 the other. Here we go. Man, shake those legs. Ow! Burning. You guys burning? I'm burning. It's good. All right, now we get to kind of let that belly burn. Get those dumbbells on the floor. One or two. Again, none are necessary. Straight up over your chest. We start with the leg lowers first. Belly's in, one leg at a time. Down, one, down, up, two, keep moving them, three, we're doing 20, four, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, one, two, anchor the back, three, four, press out of your chest. I think that was seven, eight, nine, hold it up, 10. Slowly lower down, tuck the knees in, leg extension, and slow lower down. That was one, knees in, tuck, extend, two. You got it. Three. Lower. Tuck. Extend. Four. Lower. Belly in, belly in, belly in. Yes. Tuck. Extend. Five. Squeeze those legs. In. Six. Squeeze it, squeeze it, squeeze it. Don't let the back come off the floor. Seven. You got it. In. Eight. In. Nine. Here's our last one. Extend it up. Beautiful. Bring those dumbbells down to your sides. Heels down. With. You don't want to, not within your fingertips reach is what I was trying to say. So, we cannot reach them. Crunch. Head and shoulders up. And then alternating touch. Heel or ankle. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Keep the shoulders lifted. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Belly in. Eight, nine, ten more. One, two. These go fast. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 30 and down. Are you ready for hollow holds? It's only 15 seconds. All right. Pull those knees in. Draw your belly in towards the spine. Arms overhead. Lift it. Extend the legs. Hold. One, two, three, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one. Two, three, four, five. Pull it in. Woo! That was one. We got two more like that. Enjoy your little break. Reset. Body and mind. Ready? Up. Extend. Arms and legs in. Hold. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, pull it in. Woo. Two down, one to go. All right, you ready? Pull it up, heads up, arms extended, legs out, last time. One, two, three, squeeze it, four, five, six, seven, eight, everything you got, nine, 10, one, two, three, four, five, knees in. Woo. All right, butt planks. Feet up. I'm going to try my couch this time. All right. Down. One leg or two, whatever you want. Here we go. Up and down. One, two. Keep that leg straight. Three. Think about your butt cheek. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Try not to let your toe turn out to the side, other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Beautiful. All right, we're grabbing those dumbbells, or one dumbbell. Ready? For that reach through to push up. So going into that plank position, make sure the dumbbell is positioned below your shoulder, okay, so you can reach underneath the arm. Core's tight, count every push-up, 12 times. Reach, push, down and up, one. Reaching, two. Under the arm, so across the body. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. One. And two. Nice. Here's our break, okay? Catch your breath. Your core should be tight. You should feel that. Like you got gut punched. Get a quick drink. Woo! All right, I think we got enough time to do one more. All right, get your water. We're starting with those overhead split jumps. We're gonna do that whole thing one time through. Stretch. That's it. That's it. And then you're gonna join me or stay with me for yoga because we're gonna need a stretch after this. All right, you ready? It's go time. Let's make this one our best one. So last round, okay? Sweating good. Okay, overhead. 20 times. Here we go. Down. One. Two. Three. Down and up. One. Two. Feel those obliques. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Switch it. Other side, look at that dumbbell. One. Two. Three. Get as low as you can. Four, challenge that core. Five, that shoulder stability. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine, last one. 10, perfect. All right, kick ups, sit throughs, wherever you are here. Let's go, kick. One, two, three, we're going for 12. Four, five, nine, 10, 1, 2. All righty. Wall sit for time. Grab your wall. Five. Three. Two. Arms overhead. Breathe. Navel in. Seconds. Stay with it. Enjoy the burn. Come on. 15 seconds. Don't stop now. Five, four, three, two. Done, bring it up. Oh, I like to shake it out right after. Are you ready? 180 degree squat jumps, 10 each way. Let's go. One, two. Ooh, don't fall over. Three, got dizzy. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Two, three, four, five, six. The burner's real. Seven, eight, nine. Oh, shaking it out. We're coming back onto the floor. Grabbing dumbbells. Ready for a little ab burn, a little core burn. All right. Arms extended right over your chest. Got it? You with me? All right, legs up. Here we go. Single leg lowers. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Fight to keep that other leg up. Nine, 10, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Come on, keep that back down. Last one, 10. Ready? Double leg, slowly lower. Tuck it in, extend it up. One. All the way through, circle through it. In, up, two. In, three. Four. Keeping the back down, five. Six, push out of those dumbbells, those shoulders, that chest. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. We're putting those dumbbells down. Heels down. Out of reach. Head, shoulders up. Reach up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Use those obliques. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20. We got 10 more. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 30. Heads are down. Hollow hold. Pull those knees into your chest first. Stretch it out a little bit. All right. Lift the head and shoulders. Arms extended, biceps next to your ears. Send the legs out, hold. One, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pull it in. Woo! One of three. Ready? Head up. Extend. Up. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pull it in. Woo! One more. We got this. We are in the home stretch, people. Let's do it. Head up. Extend. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Back down. 7, 8, 9, 10. Squeeze. 2, 3, 4, 5. In. Cool. Yes. Butt plank. Let's do it. I'm going to stay with my feet on the couch. I felt that that was more of a burn, a bigger contraction. Even though it's on a lower surface, I felt like I was able to work it more. So you do you. Are you ready? One leg up. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Switch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, we got a last one. Then reach through with a push-up. So keeping that dumbbell below your shoulder. Plank position, horse height. Count those push-ups, we have 12. Here we go. 1, remember you can always drop to the knees for that push-up, right? 2, that is your option. But go into the plank for the reach through. Uh-huh. Left 5. I think this is 7. Yes. 8. Child's pose. Excellent job, people. My people. My workout people. Thank you so much. Getting me up. Making me work. It feels good. All right, let's come up ball fours position. Hands and knees. Tuck your toes under your back. Press it back down, dog. Let the head hang between those arms. I'm leaking over here. Hold on. All right. Beautiful. Step 1 foot forward to the outside of your hand, just like we did. World's greatest stretch. Turn over that leg. Drop your back knee. Reach back. Quad stretch. Pull your heel to your butt. You should feel that hip flexor and quad on the kneeling leg. Release there, sit back. All the way to your heel, flex that foot, reach down for your toes. And they come on up. Hands inside the foot, tuck the toes, raise the knees, step it back, down dog. We do it to the other side, lunge. And turn, twist over that leg. Dropping your back knee, flatten out the toes, reach back for that leg, for that foot. Pull it in. We've got quad stretch, okay? Push those hips forward and down. And release it. Sit back all the way to those hips. Or to the heel, hips to the heels. Walk it down. Hamstring stretch here. Come on up, hands inside of the foot, tuck the toes, raise the knee, step back. We're coming forward into that garland pose or squatting position, hands in prayer. Beautiful, stand it up. Inhale, arms reach up. Clasp the hands behind the back, interlock the fingers, open through the chest, raise the arms back. And then release it there. One arm coming straight across, pull in front of behind the elbow, shoulders down. We're gonna take that same arm, overhead tricep stretch. Pull down on the elbows, head is lifted. Switch it, other arm straight across, shoulders down. And then arm overhead, tricep stretch. And that is it. Excellent job, you guys. Thank you.
Good job, good job, good job, Facebook land, my Zoomers. Hang in there. If you guys are staying with me for yoga, okay? Get some more water, go to the bathroom, whatever you gotta do. We got a special guest right here. Say hi.
Hi.
All right. Okay. We'll be back in, let's go, 30 seconds. Okay. Take your shoes and socks off. All right. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. We all need that yoga. We all need that stretch.
We all need that handstand.
Let me get my shoes and
there's
socks off.
Three things on school. The top school. Can I move this up just a little bit?
Yes. Are you going to use the towel?
No, because the towel is slippery. I'm going to stand here and I'm stand there.
Okay. But I'm going this way. Okay? Okay. All right. Set some music. My yogis. We are actually going to start off on our backs, okay? So we're going to lay down and get comfy. Go ahead, lay down. Bringing your arms and legs in close to the body. You want your palms up, all right?
Like this?
Yes, perfect. Let your head rest. Close your eyes while I get this music together. All right, arms and legs in close to the body, palms up. Natural curve through the lumbar spine. Just focus on your ujjayi breath here, which is in through the nose and out through the nose. Steady your breath. Try to slow it down with each inhale and exhale. Try
try to let everything else go. Being aware of your body and how you're feeling today and using that in your practice. Just letting me be a guide, but do what feels good for you. Never take anything to the point of pain. And at any moment, feel free to take a rest in child's pose, seated position, down dog, or get a drink when needed. You're gonna take that right knee and pull it in towards your chest. Interlock your fingers below the kneecap. This time we're drawing the belly in and the back flat to the floor. Pull those shoulder blades down. Tuck your chin in towards your chest. You can open the eyes here. Looking down towards your knee, but head stays on the floor. Start to rock that right knee side to side. Keep rocking it side to side. The idea is to feel that hip open up. Then we're gonna take that right knee across the body to the left. Right arm out towards the side. Keep your shoulder down. Allow your foot to relax to the floor. Should feel a nice twist through the spine. Don't compromise the form or the depth. Yes, we might get a back crack or two, and that's okay. And then bring the knee up center. And then we're gonna take our right hand to the inside of the right leg and drop that knee open. Good, we want knee in line with hip, ankle in line with knee, and then pull down onto your opposite hip with your left hand. So left hand to left hip, so that you're not rolling over to the side. Here we should feel, again, hip, inner thigh, little groin. Release the hand on the inside of the leg, extend that leg out, and then pull the left knee in towards your chest. Tailbone's tucked, small in the back, down, belly's in, shoulders down, head's relaxed. Start to rock that knee side to side. And then taking that knee across the body to the left, or sorry, to the right. Left arm extended all the way out. Keeping that left shoulder down. And then bringing that knee in towards your chest again. Well, we're going to do the correct side this time.
Oh, yeah.
So left hand to the inside of the left leg. Extend the knee open to the side. Try to keep your knee in line with your hip and your ankle in line with your knee. And then your right hand on your right hip, pulling it down. And then release there, extend that leg all the way out, pulling your knees in towards your chest, both knees here. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. From here, we're going to lift our head and shoulders off of the floor. Then extend your right leg out. Your left hand is on your left knee. Your right hand is on the inside of that left ankle. And then we switch it, pulling that right knee in. Right hand on the right knee, left hand on the inside of the ankle. Switch. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Draw the navel in. Nine. Ten more. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 20. Pull your knees in, heads relax. This time we're going to extend the legs all the way up. Turn yourself that way a little bit more. Yeah. Beautiful. Head and shoulders lifted. Reach down for your right calf or ankle. Extend that left leg down. We want to pull that in and switch. One. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten more. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20, knees into your chest, heads rest. Beautiful. We are going to roll it up, half bow position, bringing your hands to the outsides of your ankles. Roll it up and hold it in that half bow position. You come up, chin parallel, belly in. Roll it back. Don't let your head touch. Tuck your chin. Roll up, hold. Two. Down, up. Three. Down, up, four, then don't do it. Five, down, up, six, again, seven, eight, we're going to 10, nine, one more, 10. Hold it there. Release the legs. Sit up nice and tall. Chest up, belly's in. We're going to tap the floor. Straighten the legs. Extension. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Wait, hold on. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Last one. And 10, come to a seated position. Nice and tall. Cross leg, full lotus, half lotus, up of the flesh, whatever feels good for you. Sitting up nice and tall. Inhale, arms reach up. Biceps next to the ears, hinge forward from the hips. Bellies in, tailbones down. Heads hang between the arms as you relax. From here, keeping the hips down, we'll just rock a little side to side, loosening up those hips, lower back, any of those tight spaces, breathe in through the nose and out through the nose, mouth is relaxed. Take your hands, walk it over to the right side, keep the left hip and knee down, head hangs between the arms here. Walk it over to the left side, right hip and knee down. Breathe.
coming back to your center. And carefully push yourself up nice and tall, shoulders over the hips. Bringing your hands behind the hips. We want our fingertips forward, okay? I'll turn to the side. Leaning back. Chest lifted. Let the head drop back. See the wall behind you. Lock out the arms. Press the knees down and lift the hips up, opening the front side of the body. And release all the way down. Beautiful. Switching the cross of our legs. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, draw the belly and hinge forward from the hip, reach down. Letting the head hang between the arms. Belly's in every forward fold. And then start to rock a little side to side. Without rising off of those hips. Taking the hands, walk it over to the right side. Head hangs down. Belly's in. You want to feel that stretch all through the left side of the body. I'm walking the hands all the way over to the left side. Keeping that right hip and knee down. Feeling that stretch through the right side of the body. And then walking the hands forward again, big reach. And carefully push yourself up, nice and tall. Bringing the hands behind the hips again. Keep your fingertips forward. Chest lifted, head drops back. See the wall behind you. Then press the knees down, lift the hips up towards the sky. Press your knees down. Keep your fingertips forward more. Yes. Good. Think about getting your knees and your shins down on the floor. And then release. Excellent. Let's extend those legs all the way out. Coming off of the flesh underneath the hips, sit up nice and tall. Flex the feet, pulling 10 toes towards you. Inhale. Arms reach up. Exhale. Reach forward over the leg. And then carefully sitting up nice and tall. We'll swing those legs around, coming to all fours position. Hands and knees.
This one?
Nope, straight. Yep. Hands and knees. Draw the navel in. Shoulder, elbow, wrist. All in a straight line. Knees directly underneath of those hips and ankles in line with the knees. So about hips width apart. Going for a few cat cows here. Start to drop the belly and the sternum down. Inhale, look up, lift the crown of the head, lift the tailbone, full breath. Exhale, round the back, draw the navel in towards the spine. Separate the shoulder blades, tuck the tailbone, press into the floor. Do it again. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale again. You want to take as much time as you can to take that long, slow breath, filling up the lungs. And each time, each round, we take more air in. And exhale, more air out. Finish this one. And coming to your neutral spine. Tucking the toes under and back,
Lift the hips high, down dog. Pressing through those heels, let the head hang between the arms. Shake it out, shake it, yes, shake it, no, roll it around. Whatever feels good for you. Remember to press through the index fingers, thumbs, and knuckles. So when you're here, right? We're talking index finger, thumb, lots of pressure here and across all of your knuckles. Not in the heels of your hands, right? Because then our wrists will hurt. So press into those digits. Use them, they're strong. Beautiful. From here, we're going to shift our weight forward into a plank position, rolling our spine like a wave. Shoulders now come past the wrists. Elbows always go back. Chaturanga. Slowly lower down. Do not let the shoulder drop below the elbow. Push through. Up dog or cobra. Either tops of the feet or tops of the quads. Shoulders pulled down away from your ears. Yes, lengthening the spine. Hips high. Down dog. Press through those heels. Raising that right leg up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Holding that leg up. Now this is an option. Makes it a little bit more challenging. Come forward to plank. Slowly lower down, chaturanga. Push through to up dog. Tops of the feet. Exhale. Down dog. Hips high. Again, left leg reaching up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Then shift that shoulder forward. Elbows in, chaturanga. Single leg if you can. Push through up dog. Exhale. Down dog. Hips are high. Looking between the hands. Walk or step forward into your fold. Feet separated, hips width apart, hanging over the legs. Inhale, flat back. Lift the crown of the head and the tailbone. Flatten out the back. Pull those shoulder blades back. Exhale, fold. Reaching for opposite elbows here. And then rock or sway side to side. Good, just letting everything go. Bathroom break if you're wondering. Wondering where our guest star went. Coming back to center, release those arms. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. And slowly roll it up. Ragdoll. Nice and tall. Shoulders over the hips. Inhale, arms reach up. Hands in prayer. Sink back to your chair. Weight is in your heels. Chest up, belly's in. Lift those toes, wiggle them around. Make sure the knees do not pass the toes. Come tall to stand, raise your right knee. Arms reach up. Come down to chair. Come tall to stand, raise your left knee. Find that balance. Knee in line with hip, come down. Raise your right knee. To chair, raise your left knee. To chair, raise your right. To chair, one more time, raise your left. To chair. Releasing hands to the floor, straightening the legs. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Walk, step or hop back to plank.
Elbows in, chaturanga.
Push through, up dog.
Exhale, down dog.
Hips are high. Pressing through those heels, head hangs down. Right leg reaching up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Right foot steps forward to the outside of the hand. Lunge.
Fingertips and toes in a line. Turn, twist over the right leg. Chin to your shoulder. Looking up towards the sky. Reach up. Press. Breathe in through the nose and out through the nose. Bringing that right elbow, come down, touch the floor inside of the right foot. Only come as low as you can. Turn, twist, reach up again. Do it again. Down, touch the floor. Turn, twist, reach up. One more time, touch the floor. Hand is to the floor, stepping back.
Down dog. Shift the shoulders forward again.
Plank. Elbows in, chaturanga.
Push through, up dog.
Exhale, down dog, hips high.
Breathing there, left leg reaches up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Left foot steps forward to the outside of your left hand.
Lunge. Chest lifted.
Turn, twist over that left leg. Chin to your left shoulder.
Press forward and down into those hips. Keeping the hips the same level, drop your left elbow to the floor inside of the left foot
and reach it up. Elbow to the floor or as close to it as you can get and reach up. One more time, elbow to the floor and then hand to the floor.
Step back,
down dog. Shift the shoulders forward.
Plank, elbows in, chaturanga, up dog,
down dog, hips high. Beautiful, looking between the hands, walk, step, hop forward into your fold. Sink the hips down, arms reach up to chair.
Make sure that you sit back, right? We don't want our knees to come forward. So you draw your hips back, really squeeze your abs. Should feel, you're on that teeter of falling back. Come tall to stand, arch back, little back bend. Hands in prayer. Nice and tall. All right, keep your eyes open. We are raising our right leg.
Good. Find the balance.
You need a balance.
Ankle across the top of right knee. Press that knee back and down. Really open those hips up. Yes. And then sink back, single leg chair.
Shin parallel to the ground.
Come tall to stand. Raise the knee.
Keeping those hands in prayer, we're going warrior three. Extending that right leg back. Chest down, leg up. Your hips are square. The right inner thigh rotates up towards the sky. The toes are pointed towards the ground. Lengthen through the spine and the crown of the head. Come tall to stand, feet side by side. flow through. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, dive forward into your fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Walk, step, hop back to plank. Elbows in, chaturanga down. Push through, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Press through the heels. Looking between the hands, walk, step, hop forward into your fold. Sink down to chair here, arms reach up. Don't let your feet turn up, turn in. Not so much, straight. Yeah, right there. Good, come tall to stand. Arch back. Hands in prayer, eyes are forward. Draw the navel in. Raise that left knee. Knee in line with hip, foot flexed, flex. Yep. The reason we flex it, when we cross it over, it helps to protect our knee, okay? So flex that foot, press the knee back and down, and then sink down, hinge from the hip. Belly's in. Continue that ujjayi breath from tall to stand. Raise the knee. Find that balance. Warrior three, hinge from the hip. Keep the hands in prayer. Extend your left leg back. Chest down, leg up. We want to keep those toes pointed towards the ground. Left inner thigh rotating up towards the sky. Look at that spot on the floor about 3 feet in front of you. Then come tall to stand. Feet side by side.
Why is that so hard?
It is hard. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, dive forward, fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Walk, step, hop that plank. Elbows in, chaturanga. Lower down. Up dog. Exhale, down dog, hips high. Take a rest here in down dog or child's pose. Regain your breath. Find it if you've lost your way. In through the nose and out through the nose. Beautiful. Right leg reaching up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Right foot steps forward between the hands. Arms reach up between the hands, dear. Between the hands. Arms reach up. You can always take it down to that lower level with the knee on the floor. It's absolutely fine. This is called crescent lunge, okay? We're rising. Chest up, belly's in. Breathe. Release hands to the floor. Step back, down dog. Press through those heels. Left leg reaches up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Left foot steps forward. Crescent lunge right between the hands. Arms up. Push forward and down. Ujjayi breath, breathe. Release hands to the floor. Step back. Down dog. Press. Right through those heels, chest back. Come forward to plank. Elbows in, chaturanga. Up dog. Exhale, down dog. Hips are high. Pressing through those heels. Looking between the hands, walk, step, hop forward into your fold. Heels and toes come together this time. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Sinking down to chair. Arms reach up. Biceps next to the ears. Weight is in the heels. Chest up. Look up. Come tall to stand. Arch back. Hands are in prayer. And eyes forward.
Why do I keep getting
dizzy? Are you closing your eyes?
No.
Is anybody else getting dizzy coming out of that? If you are, the way to correct the dizziness is think about lifting through your sternum here. And you want to see. Imagine there's a line that goes right through your eyesight, okay? Up to the wall, back to the ceiling, to the back wall, and then you follow it all the way. You have to go slow, because if you come out of it so fast, you don't see the line, and then that's when you get disoriented, okay? So, slow, breathe, don't hold your breath through it, follow the line, all right? Standing in prayer position. Beautiful. We're gonna take our right foot, step back, warrior one. Back foot turns out flat, 45 degrees. So that we line up, our front heel lines up with the arch of the back foot. Good. Arms reach up, hips and shoulders are square. Don't turn it well, it should be straight. Straight, and then.
We're all used to gymnastics.
I know, but this is not gymnastics, is it? It is yoga.
Stretching.
Good. Hands in prayer here. Keep that knee bent. Watch that. Do not shift it back, okay? You are going to feel this leg to start to do some work here. It's warming up. Arms extended out. Chest lifted. Belly's in. Squeeze those triceps. You want to make them strong. Imagine if you ever to come down and put weights on your arms. They're not going to drop. They're not going to wilt at your sides, right? Your shoulders are strong. Your triceps are strong. Your chest is lifted. Yeah. Flip the palm up. Reach forward. Bend. Arch. Back. Reverse warrior. Your right hand is above or below your back knee joint. Never on your knee. Around the back, unsupported. Rotate through the torso, chest lifted. And then we're going to straighten that right leg. Now we get a little relief here. Feel that, or sorry, that left leg. Feel that whole left side open up. Come up, triangle prep. Shoulders over the hips. Again, we were in that back bend. Follow that line up, okay? Lock out this leg. Squeeze it so tight, so strong. Hinge forward from the hip. Head of the femur sinks into that hip socket. Reach. Try to get chin towards shoulder. Look, gaze, past those fingertips. Now, what you don't want to do, right? I'm coming forward for you. What you don't want to do is this. Do not do that. Okay? Keep yourself in that straight line. Hinge as far forward as you can. And then you drop the fingertips light. Turn, twist, chin to your shoulder. Again, the pelvis is pressed forward. So, not here. If you're here, it's likely that you are restricted in your hamstring. So you need to come up and come here, okay? Do not compromise form for the depth of the stretch. Do what you can. It's a journey. On our journey, we have good days and bad. Days that we are feeling good, fresh, days are feeling sore and tired. However you're feeling today, use that. Then we're coming down right angle. So we bend our knee. Shift your elbow, forearm, onto your knee. Keeping that arm up. Slide the hand down if you can. Again, we're not inside of the leg like this. Not like that. Crown of the head goes forward, tailbone goes back. Yep. You need to bend your knee more. Good. Stay there. Arm reaches up. So see, this is a correction here. Look up to me. Now look up to your fingers. Where are your fingers reaching? Good. This is way better. Way better. Way better than that inside position that she had before, right? So we're here. And if you see, everything lines up. Fingertips and toes, arm and leg, shoulder and knee. Then that right arm is reaching overhead. Beautiful. We're going to press into that left hand. Step it back. Side plank. Her leg's dying. Is your leg dying? That's okay. Hold it up. We're going to get a break in a minute. Or maybe like 15 seconds. Breathe. Keep those hips high. Arms maybe shaking. It's okay. Come on. We're getting stronger. Three, two, rotate forward to your plank. Don't drop. How about we add in five chaturanga push-ups?
No.
I say yes. Ready? Down and up. One, down and up. Two, don't drop to the floor. Three, you can do the knees.
Okay.
Four, and five. Hips high, down dog, or take your rest in child's pose. Whatever you'd like. Ujjayi breath, in through the nose and out through the nose. Looking between the hands, walk, step, hop forward into your full heels and toes together. Yeah. Sink down to chair, arms reach up. Weight is in your heels, in your heels. Yes. Come tall to stand. Arch back, reach back. Now, follow that line, slow up. Lift from the sternum, come forward, and then the chin comes parallel, jaw parallel to the ground. Beautiful. Hands in prayer position. Then, are you taking a break?
Yes.
Then, we are going to step that left foot back. Warrior, I'll go this way. Left foot back, warrior one. Hips and shoulders square. Hold it here. Draw the navel in towards the spine. Remember, that front heel lines up with the arch of the back foot. We're rotating, bringing that left hip forward. Bring your hands in prayer. Open, warrior two. Chest lift, you're gazing past your fingertips. Squeeze those triceps. Chest lifted. Shoulders strong. Breathe. Then we flip that front palm. Reach forward. I still am having this bend in my knee over my ankle. Arch back, reach back. Your left hand above or below the back knee joint. Wrapped around the back. Palm open. Unsupported, rotate back, then we straighten that right leg, arch back more, squeeze it, flex it, coming up, triangle prep, shoulders over hips, locking out that front leg, hinge from the hip, reach down, reach forward. Think chin to your shoulder. bend. Drop the fingertips light towards the floor. Remember, we are in this straight line. So if you notice that you start to do this, right, we need to bring it back here by pushing the pelvis forward and pulling those shoulders back, twisting a little bit more from the waist. Breathe, lock out that leg, you want to squeeze it. No bending that front knee. Then coming down, bend that right knee. You can go forearm on the knee or hand to the floor. It really just depends on your flexibility. Sink those hips down, turning, twisting. Remember, crown of the head's forward. I'm not inside here. I pull it back. Press into that floor, step. Right leg back, side plank, and we hold it here. Keep it lifted. So we got a few seconds hold, about 20 to 30. You got this. You're strong. You're steadying your breath. You're breathing. Even if you feel like your arm is shaking, I want you to hold it. Squeeze your butt. Lift those hips up towards the sky. And then we come forward to your plank. And guess what? We did it on the other side. We got to do it here too. Five chaturanga push-ups. Option to go to the knees. But I want you to push yourself, okay? I want you to really try. We got two more. Four, one more time. Five, and then we go hips high. Down dog, to rest. Breathing there. Reaching that right leg up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Bringing the right shin forward to pigeon. Shin parallel to the top edge of the mat. Walking those hands back. Try to get shoulders over hips. Breathe. Think about drawing that navel in towards the spine. Settling down. We do not want to roll onto our right hip, okay? So keep everything stacked. And coming over, I'll show you here. Let me make my way. Coming over that leg into reclining pigeon. So only coming down as far as you can. What you want to try to have is flat back here, right? So I'm not rolling over onto this side, okay? So you should feel the right hip and glute. That's where you feel the stretch. Let your head relax. Enjoy this rest here. Focus on your breath. Heart rate's coming down. And then we're going to push ourselves up nice and tall. And then you are going to sit on that hip. Keeping your right foot pulled in towards your groin. Sit up nice and tall. That left leg is extended out. And then we're going to go forward. Reaching down the middle.
and carefully push yourself up. Then we extend that right leg out. Hands behind the hips, sit up nice and tall into a straddle. We'll have to do it over there in front of you. Good, then we bring our hands forward. Keep your back flat. So from the side, I'll rotate to the side. Sitting tall, what we don't want to happen is this. Do not let that happen, okay? Sit up nice and tall, and then start to hinge forward from the hips. Coming all the way down, wherever you can. Thinking about dropping your belly, then your chest, and then your head. Going into that pancake pose, trying to be flat. Inner thigh, groin, hamstring. And then carefully pushing yourself up. With the help of the hands underneath the knees, bring them in. And then come back to that all fours position. Hands and knees. Tuck the toes under and back. Lift the hips high. Down dog. And then we're going left leg reaching up towards the sky. Three-legged dog. Big reach. Left shin comes forward to pigeon. Bringing that shin all the way up. And then remember, you are not rolling onto that left hip. Stack shoulders over hips. Settling down, opening the glute, opening the hip. And then coming over, I'm going to come this way. Coming over that front leg into reclining pigeon. So you see how Eva's rolling onto her hip? That's incorrect. So roll the other way, honey.
It hurts my foot on the ground.
Then don't go so low. Come up more.
Okay.
I'm in up onto your hands. Is that better?
Heel on my hip and it'll all be okay.
The idea is to get your heel or your foot as far away from your hip or your groin as possible, right? So ideally parallel to the top edge of your mat, right? So trying to bring it up here rather than having the foot back here. But again, that's just takes time, it takes mobility, flexibility. And some people are just naturally flexible, some people have to work on it. Wherever you are, whichever one you are, don't give up. Good, relaxing into that glute and hip. And then we're gonna carefully push ourselves up. Good, sitting on that left hip, extending the right leg out. Sit up nice and tall, we keep that left foot pulled in and then hinge forward down the center. And then we're carefully push it up. Nice and tall, going right into that straddle. Extend the legs out. Hands start behind your hips first. I'll turn this way. Behind your hips first.
I need to have my feet on here.
Okay, but you should probably back up. And then we're going to bring our hands forward. Remember, stacking nice and tall. One vertebrae over the other. Nice and tall. Extending through the crown of the head. Come forward. Hinge. Don't round the back. Wiggle down into that pancake pose. You got this. Breathe. Try to relax as much as possible into that deep stretch. And then carefully push yourself up. Nice and tall. With the help of the hands underneath the knees, bring them in. And then we come to child's pose. Sitting the hips back to the heels. I go this way. And then we're coming up. Hero's pose. Just sit back onto those heels. Try to stay on the tops of your feet, okay? Nice and tall. Belly's in. Very nice. Kind of just stretching out those ankles, should feel nice. And then we're going to do the same, but tuck the toes under and sit back here. Stretching out those toes. Does it feel good? Does it hurt?
Hurts my baby toe.
All right, we want to try to sit up tall. There. All right, we're going to come off of those feet.
Oh, thank you.
Have a seat, and then we're going to lie back. Feet flat on the floor. Roll it back. Reach down, bring those heels in. You can feel the backs of your heels. Then lifting the hips up towards the sky and bridge.
I can't have my head on.
Let's go down. Good, wiggling those shoulders underneath the back, palms up. Keeping the heels down.
With the powder.
Yes, better.
My back of my head hurts now.
Don't turn your head. Don't turn your head, you guys. You gotta look straight down the center line of your body. All right, everybody coming down. Let's go into chest expansion, okay? Lift the hips up towards the sky into your bridge. Interlock your hands underneath your back. Wiggle the shoulders. Chin to your chest. Press the hips high. Release the hands first, and then release the hips.
shoulders move out of the way. One more. Any variation of bridge that you like, I'll talk you through wheel, which is essentially a back bend. We'll bring fingertips towards your shoulders. Elbows into the head. Lift your hips up first. Now, follow the directions you go. Lift your hips up first. Bring your chin away from your chest. Come to the crown of your head, the top of your head. Press into your hands harder. Then straighten the arms and lift the pelvis, open the chest, all the way up. Keep breathing here. The way we win is the way we come out. Bend your elbows, bring the crown of your head down. Tuck your chin, back up the head, and then drop the hips. Shoulders move out of the way. Pull your knees in towards your chest. Don't worry if you didn't get all the way into wheel. It's a process, as with some of those inversions and other postures we do. If you keep practicing, you will get there. You just have to have patience with yourself. And always work on those skills that you want to accomplish. A few times a week, 5-10 minutes, that's all you need. And dropping the knees over to the right side. Back bend. Allow the feet to relax to the floor. Your left shoulder's on the floor. Steady breath. Bringing the knees up center and drop it over to the left side. Right shoulder is on the floor. And then bringing knees up center. Relax feet to the floor, arms extended all the way out. Arms and legs in close to the body. Focusing on that ujjayi breath in through the nose and out through the nose. I want you to take a few deep breaths in. All through the nose, exhale. All through the nose. Again, inhale. Exhale. One more. Excellent job, everybody. Go ahead and reaching those arms overhead. Open the mouth and yawn, stretch out the jaw, open the eyes, turn over onto your right side. And carefully push yourself up, nice and tall, seated posture, where we can honor ourselves and any company that we have. Thank you so much, everybody. Thumbs to the third eye. Namaste. I will see you soon. Thanks, everybody.
Facebook people.
Bye, people.
Thank you, Zoom people. I will see you soon. All right, stay strong, people.
Namaste.
Thank you. Hi.
Hey, Courtney, thank you.
Thank you.